happen. We've got a great IT, the AnitaB IT team on the line to answer all your questions. You have Talanda Williams from our team that is going to be presenting to y'all. And then I'm going to transition it really quickly to Lucia, our COO, to give you a brief note before Talanda actually walks you through the platform. And by the way, my name is Christine Villarreal, and I head up business development, and I love working with all of you. So thank you for the opportunity.
Excellent. I'm going to be just as quick. I'm here to say that what you're going to see today is a direct response to the responses you gave us to surveys, as well as the feedback that you've given. I am going to turn it right over to our IT team members who are going to take you through a presentation of the resume database and the job board that is powered by YM. And I'll be back with you at the very end. So, Talanda, one more thing I was going to say is that there are lots of slides in this deck. Those slides are meant to be a leave behind more than to go through on this in this moment. Most of our presentation today will actually be in the system. Okay, so with that, Talanda, go.
Awesome. Hi. So I'm going to go over our resume database and job board. So collectively they're at the Career Center, and those two aspects are the resume database and the job board. So in the resume database, there is the bank that has all of the candidate information that you can access. And then there is the new for this year, the job board, where you can post a job, manage those jobs that you've posted, and create templates so that you can easily create more jobs. And so this is sort of our agenda for the demo that we're going to go through. Just highlighting that we've removed the anonymization, we've removed the employer validation, so once you register, you're all set to go. We have the new job board, which I'll go over, additional filters based on your requests, the candidate profile reports, which is really exciting, you'll see when we get there, and download access to the bulk resume files. So with that, I will stop the presentation, and like Lucia said, there are a lot more slides that you'll be able to access after this meeting. So this is our Career Center website. Let me just move Zoom out of the way. All right. So the first thing you'll want to do here is log in or register. So if you have an account already, you can log back in. If you don't, you can fill out your information, your company information, and just make an account right here. Once you're registered, you'll access the My Account page. It's your first page on login. The first thing you'll want to do is actually register for the event. So you'll see Virtual GHC Resume Database 2020 here, and you'll click on Register. All right, so the various sponsorship levels receive access at various times, but they all expire at the end of December the 31st, 2020. So you will receive an email with an access code, which I'll show you on the next page where that goes, and it will correspond to your sponsorship level. So you'll select that here and hit register. And then this is the page where it will show you the price, but you have already paid for that in your sponsorship. So you'll use the code that was sent to you. So in this case, I'm going to use demo, add the coupon, which will remove the value and any owed. So you'll just be able to go through here and click complete order.
Hey, Talanda,
I'm gonna break in for a moment and say, all of us need to take a deep breath. We've gotten a request that we slow down some. We have all day. For the next 45 minutes or so, and let's just take a breath and slow down some. That's a great suggestion. I didn't see who put it in the chat. I saw the pop-up. But yes, let's slow down just a little bit.
All right, sorry about that. Okay, so once you're registered, we're gonna go back to the My Account page and just highlight some of the features. So as I mentioned, we're going to first go over the job posting. So on here, you would click post a job, and it'll take you to this page. So on your post a job settings is where you're gonna put all the information that's relevant for that job. So starting with the name and then going on. For this purpose, you can also see that once you have entered information, you can save it as a template so you can use it for later. So I'm going to open up the demo template that I've created as an example, and you'll see that fills in some fields that you might have comment over across your various job position postings. So in here, you'll go just scrolling down, you'll see the description, the requirements, and the various fields. Some are required with the red asterisks and some are not. And then there's location. So you can enter the location here, state and country, If you would like to do a remote position, you can enter other in the state field and type in here. As you can see, I've added a location already. Otherwise, I can say add California and add that location here. After you've gotten your job posting information all configured and entered as you like, you have a contact person that would receive those applicant information and notifications. So in this case, myself and Lynn are registered under this company. And so I would have myself as who I want to receive the applicants for this job posting. So I'm going to continue on. The various sponsorship levels have different access to unlimited job postings for a particular amount of time. So that varies based on sponsorship, but each job posting is opened by default for 30 days. So in this case, I'm on an account that already has unlimited job postings for a period for this period of time, and I would just continue onward. If you've passed the time frame that you have free postings, or you're on an account that doesn't have free postings, you would see the cost here, or you could also talk to your PD account managers. And so I'll complete this order, and you'll see an email. Now I could view the job that I just created by going to my jobs. So I have two jobs now, one that I've done earlier and then the one that I just added with California as the location. So this is where you can see the status of your jobs. With that 30-day notice, you'll see that there's the end date right here and that right now this one's active. So I could deactivate it, say I've reached enough applicants for the position that I had open. I could view those applicants here, change the job settings, edit this position itself, and view the live job page. So this is the general overview of the new job board section. Are there any questions, or do we want to hold all the questions to the end?
Maybe we can stop and ask and answer a few questions that are in the Q&A, because they're starting to accumulate there. And Crystal is doing a good job of helping us manage them. Also, for Lynn and Sumita, can you jump into the Q&A and answer some questions? But maybe, Crystal, you can guide us through a couple of the questions that are sitting in the Q&A before we move on to the next section. Sometimes it's very helpful to understand the answer to the question while your brain is still on that question.
Yep, I got it. I'll ask some of the questions in here. So one is, if your job is in multiple locations, can you select multiple or do you need to post a new job for each location?
Now you can select multiple locations for your job. So in the example one that I just created, let me scroll back down to location, they all populate over here. So on the left hand of this panel is locations that I entered for this job. And then the right hand is just where I would select which ones to put. So I could add other states, I could be more specific and add the city, the zip. If you need something that's more particular, you could fill out other and then add that here. As the only thing with other is that it does require to still say what the country is. Of course, that can still be whatever you need and add it here. And then they will all show on this side for the job.
Thank you for that. Another question, is there a companion document that breaks down the steps that, oh, somebody just went ahead and answered that. They typed it out, okay. How many people are you able to list to receive notifications?
You can select as many registrants that you have under your company here. I do not believe there is any limit there. I'm sure someone on the team can correct me if I'm wrong there, but in this case, all the red entrants that I have under this particular company, which in this case is myself and Lynn, I could select both of us and we would all receive the email notifications, or I could do a subset of that.
Okay, awesome. Just let me know how many more questions you want and if you want to keep going. Otherwise, we have folks on IT who are also answering questions, but I can ask a few more live if you'd like.
Let's see if we have another one live, and then I'm sure the team is going to finish going through these questions.
Okay, awesome. Is there an option to scrape our jobs, or do we have to post each job individually?
That might be a question for someone else on the team. As far as Is Lynn, are you, were you about to say something? Okay.
Yeah, yes, for there's a way to do for the scraping, but I would like to have the company to send a support case to us, that we will talk to you with more details.
Right. So I didn't quite hear that. I think she said there's an option for scraping, but I know you can do template based, so you can create a template and then use that template over and over.
Yes, right. I think the question is based on if they have to basically if their career website has, you know, millions of jobs, do they have to do one by one, create it one by one, or is it a way that we can mass create it for them? So there are several ways to do that. So I can chat with them, you know, offline. So if you can just submit just send your question to resume support at AnitaB.org, and I'm happy to chat with you more in details.
Great, and we'll get that email put in the chat as well.
And Talanda, this is Christine. I wanted to note that there's been the same question asked a couple times in chat and in the Q&A section. So I do want to remind folks, if you don't mind putting all of your questions in the Q&A section, if you go down and look at the bottom bar, on the far right it says Q&A, and that's where the whole team is actually trying to type in fiercely to give you responses. But the one question that continues to be asked is, when will you receive credentials or your login? So each sponsor level has a determined date on which they receive access. So for example, this past Monday, July 6th, the Emerald sponsorship level received access to the resume database. They receive credentials via email. Now moving forward, every sponsor level should know, it's listed in your package. If not, feel free to ask us which date you have access to the database. You will receive your credentials a few days before your access date via email, and that will go to the point person that we have on file. So if it comes to Thursday or Friday before you're supposed to have access on Monday and you haven't seen credentials, please reach out to your BDE or your AM. Thank you.
Awesome, thank you for that. And we should have time at the end for extra questions. So as you go through and as I go through, if anything comes up, you can also continue to put them in the Q&A section and we'll answer them. And if we don't get to them, we'll definitely keep a log of them all so that we can get back to you on them. Okay, so switching gears a little bit, we're going to go into the resume bank portion of this. So this is the resume database section. So under employers, you would just go to resume bank. And this will bring you here. So the resume bank is where you'll get all the information for all the candidates that are in our system. So if you have a particular keyword that you like to search, if you're looking for a particular skill, you could put those right here in this search bar. We also have filters. So we've added filters based on the feedback that we received to make it easier for you as well. So for instance, some of those include the government security clearance section, where you can select that. The preferred location by state, and the other option does show in here as well, so that's where remote and whatnot would show up. The graduation year is another feature, and then once you have your search figured out exactly as you would like, you can save that search here at the bottom and give it a name and just select save. So once you have a saved search, you can then, you'll see this option on the right where you'll be able to select it. So for instance, I created one that were graduates of this year that are in California. And that pulls up the various results that are here for that. So that dramatically lowered my answers. So I have a much more manageable list now to look at. So in this sense, you can then go view the candidate or bookmark them if you'd like to see your bookmarks across your various registrants that you have on your company. The view candidate page will give you all the information that we have about the candidate. So you have the information at the top, the profile information that they filled out, and then the resume itself. So YM does parse through these resumes like many applicant tracking systems. So they won't all retain their formatting, but this one did. So it's a nice example. You also have the ability to save as a PDF. So at the top right here, I'll show you, click save PDF, and that'll download to your system. And I have one open already just to show you. You can see that same profile information is at the top in the table form, and then you have the actual resume information saved here. So you'll have that as a PDF I know there's a lot of information that's on here, so it's important to just realize that the keyword search at the first page that on the search result does pull information from the profile and the resume to get you the closest results you can to that sort of keyword that you're looking for. Are there any questions on the resume bank portion before I go into the next section?
Yes, how many resumes are in the bank?
Right now, there are a little over 15,000. So we have the push that we've done this year that for new updated resumes to make sure that everyone in the system is still actively looking and that sort of thing as well. But in the bank total, we have 15,000.
Okay. Folks are curious if they'll be able to bulk download.
We will get to that in the next section. There is not an option for the bulk download here. You do have the filter and the save searches for everything to manage within this site, but we do have two alternative solutions for you for bulk downloads.
So with that, Talanda, maybe we can move through the presentation and see if some of the questions are answered. And I will ask our great technical team to continue to answer questions in the Q&A, please.
Awesome. Okay, so the next is, for this, we're gonna go back to the My Account page, and I'm gonna show you the candidate profile report. So this is one of the first options for that sort of mass download alternative that we have for you. So this was highly requested, and we're so happy to be able to show it off. So the candidate reports files you'll find on your My Account under downloads. So I have that virtual JHC Resume Database 2020 event, right, that I registered for. And the number of resumes that it has under that for the most recent time period. This file will be updated nightly, sorry. And so this will be a zip file of a CSV. So I have one open and enlarged already. So I will show you what that looks like. So once you've downloaded that file, it's just a CSV. And it has all the information that we have about all the candidates. So you can use this and Excel filtering to get the exact candidates that you're looking for as well. So there's the links right here, which will take you right back to that candidate profile that had the candidate information as well as the resume and all of their information. So this varies from when they last logged in. So to make sure you have the most up-to-date information, their legal work status, if they're attending our events, and all of the filter information is here as well. So you can look for their education status, the university that they've attended last, when they're graduating, if they've already graduated, their positions, any sort of question that you could think of, all the information that we have in the platform is available on these candidate reports of their profiles. So their industry experience, their skills, and sorry, I'm trying not to scroll too fast to not give anyone a headache, but there is a lot of information and I just want to highlight it for you all. So like the skills, for instance, the English, languages, military experience, that government security option question just to point it out, and types of positions. So all of the information that you can think of that we collect from them is available on this candidate report.
Also, can you talk a little bit, either you or Lynn, about the ordering? Because I think that was one of the requests that came from last year around the job experience. So we've ordered things in this document so that you can tell what the most recent job experience is.
Lynn, oh, yeah. So
go ahead.
I'm sorry, there's a bit of an echo. And then Lynn, please jump in. She's our internal guru on this.
Yes. Do you want me to say something or?
Yeah, go Lynn.
Go ahead. So, yeah, if you scroll the document to the far end, to the very right-hand side, then you will find the candidate's job experience. So the job one, position one or job one, that's the most recent job that, the current job that they currently have. And then the job two or the position two will be, the prior position or the their work experience, similar to the degree one, degree two. So degree one is their education details. So the degree one will be the most current one, and then so enforced. So in this document, we limited to 3 degrees and then 4 job experience. So then you can have the most current updated work experience and education status.
Yeah, so this was in direct response to requests that we had from previous versions where our sponsors wanted to be able to identify the job that somebody was currently working or was just or had just left, and the same with the degree. So we've implemented that in this report. And I will now mute and let you go ahead. Go ahead, Talanda.
No problem. So as you can see, there's just a lot of information, a wealth of information for you to use for your various filtering and searching of the candidates that you would like to select. Okay, so to switch gears a moment again. So I mentioned we had two options for your kind of mass download solution. So one is that candidate report profile that you can access and filter and do everything that you need in Excel. The other is the bulk download site that we've made new. So just to quickly point out, remember that I said that you could take the PDF version of all of the candidate information, and that has the profile and then the resume. So we've made a site that holds all that information that we've pulled from IAM's database and put onto our own secure site specifically for you all. So it looks like this. This is our hub information. That the access information will also be in that email that you'll receive, just like for the main Career Center site. So this is a secured site. It's not a SharePoint site. I know there were some questions about that last time, so I'll just preempt that there. We made it in-house specifically for this. So if you try to click on the resume downloads page without being logged in or registered, or say you send it to someone, you'll notice that they don't have access. This is something that you must log in or register for. And the registration is handled similarly to other sites. You have your main information, your name, email, password, but you also have that registration code that you use. So in the first step of the Career Center, I had that demo code that I used to register for the GHC resume database access. And so in this case, I would use that same code here to register for this account. So this gives you immediate access while maintaining that you are someone who's supposed to have access to this site. All right, so what's special about it? This is what it actually looks like. So once you're logged in, you'll have this resume downloads page that you'll have access to. And this has all of those PDF resumes zipped by a time period. So you can see our last cycle from 2019 to the end of April, we have the number of resumes in that file. And then monthly, we've continued on. So we have May, June, and since we're still in July, and we expect July to be a high period of activity, we're breaking it down further by week. So once we have the next week of July imported in here, say you wanted to get just that, you could either download the files individually here with this download button, or you could select which ones you'd like to download and then select download selected up here. We have this filtering on the side to make it easier for you to see. For now, of course, as you can see, May and June is just May and June, so there's only the one in here. But in July, there you'd have the week ones, you'd be able to select the 4 weeks and then download them all. And we'll continue to upload them weekly while we have these high periods of activity, so from July at least through GHC. And that the day that we're uploading those will be on Mondays. And so just to be, just to clarify, these are zip files of all those PDFs, and the PDFs are in the format of last name underscore first name underscore candidate ID. So I have an example here, I've downloaded them, and you can see this is just a big zip of all the resumes that are in the profile by the candidate's name. So we made it very easy for you to be able to mass download, but then still have a way of telling apart which each PDF actually is. Okay, so are there any questions on that or anything else that we've gone over that is kind of lingering in the Q&A or on someone's mind?
There are a couple questions coming through about bookmarks. So where do you go, or can you walk us through how to look at all of your bookmarks in one place? And then another question regarding bookmarks, if you bookmark or review a candidate, is there a way to avoid seeing that person in future searches?
Okay, so back to the resume bank. Let me just go over here. There was this bookmark option here, right? So I can bookmark some candidates, and you would see that again by going to your filter here and selecting bookmarked. And then this will just show me the candidates that I have bookmarked. There is not a filter the opposite way to only show candidates that you haven't bookmarked, but we can write that down as something that is an interested feature request for future.
And then just trying to get at questions that are coming through multiple times. So is there a way to distinguish new candidates versus candidates already viewed in the search results?
So there is a sort here for by last updated. So they make sure you're getting the most information that's up to date. And you can see with the results when they were last updated here. So if you know that you've last checked a month ago, and everyone is since then, you know that you have the most accurate information for that. There is also information, I believe, in here. You can mark if you've viewed someone already. Again, that doesn't do the opposite of if you haven't viewed them, but there is an option that if you notice someone but didn't actually bookmark it, was hoping to go back to find them, you can do that there. The second part of the question, I'm sorry, what was it?
Are you able to see sorry about that. I think it went into another queue already.
It did. So I know that the second question that Deb had is, can you filter by industry at the bulk download report? Oh, she typed it back in. Yep.
Oh, okay. So in the bulk download report, this is purely just by month and week at this case in this time frame. So it's just time frames. We do have like the information of when we've done it, but there's no searching capabilities here. Ideally, all of the searching capabilities would be from that candidate report profile, where you could take the document here, pull the filter that you want, and just grab those types, and then use the corresponding links. So let me quickly go back to the front to see those individual candidates here.
So you would use Excel native functionality to search for a particular industry in the industry field. That would allow you to select the candidates that you're interested in, and then you can click through using the link directly to the candidate's information, their profile, and their resume. Is that correct?
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then additionally, there's of course the filters built into YM that have like industry experience sections here that you could do as well. Some of the fields on the candidate report file, like skills, isn't on this filter, so that would be best used on the candidate reports, but some of them are on both, and you could ideally do it here and then just save that as a search.
So Wanda, we're getting a few questions around being able to search for candidates specifically for like a PhD student and a specific graduation year. Can you show them how they can combine filters to get those results back?
And while you're doing that, I'd like to introduce our Director of IT, Colby Morgan.
Hi, Colby. Hi, everyone.
Yes, so in both the YM filtering itself, as well as in the candidate report profile, you can do that search. So the example of a PhD student, right, for this year or next screen is already a default thing in here, actually. And then there's also a case where you could say a postdoctorate here, and then put the graduation year as this year. So in this case, for things that are particularly for this year, we have a nice simple version of that up here. But if it was, say, you're looking particularly for 2021, then you could do any of these levels and then put the year here and then do that search and get those results. And that similarly, you can use, of course, Excel's native function for filtering on the candidate report profile to get that information too. Hopefully that answered that question.
I think we have some additional clarity, additional clarity around how you access the candidate profile report. And I just want to make the distinction that the candidate profile report is a collection of all of the profiles that are on the application. So it's not a direct download of your search results that are being exported in this Excel file.
Yes, exactly. So the candidate profile reports, it's a tongue twister if you keep saying it, is on your My Account page. So once you log in, this is the first page it takes you to, but you can also go from Employers My Account, and it's this download section. So in this case, we have our various events that show in here. for now, we have the virtual GHC resume database, and it's just this file. And so this is actually a zip, but it just contains one CSV file. So you just extract that and then get your CSV file, which is exactly this file that I've showed.
And while we're on download, so not sure if you covered this, excuse me, I'm kind of filtering through these. So is there a way to know what we've already downloaded? And then will downloads only include weekly resumes or total to date?
So the candidate report profiles is updated nightly. So it will just give you an updated list every time. So if you pulled one last week, you could just override that list with this new list because it will have the most up-to-date information, assuming someone might have updated their old profile or anything like that. For the resume download site for that second part, that's why we're splitting it up into weeks so that you can easily download whatever you need. So in this case, we're only in the first week of July, so there's just July week one in here. But once we get through the rest of it, say you already have gotten week one, you can select just week three and download either just that one or download here. But it will just be those particular resumes that were submitted during that week. And if someone had submitted something in week one, say, and then updated again in week three, it would be in both of those folders. So you would just override the week one version with the week three. Hopefully that makes sense.
And then last thing, before you, if you want to keep going after this, can you go over how you got the CSV file with 2,200 resumes? Like, is that a saved search?
So I think that there's a, they want to understand if we have 15,000 resumes in the bank, the candidate profile report is currently showing
2,200.
What's the difference between those two numbers?
Right. Okay. So the candidate profile reports, I believe, is as of the most recent ones. So between May and June and then July, of course, you'll see like here that that number would equal, right? The July, June, and May numbers. So those are the most recent candidate or profile information that we have. So we didn't include anything from 2019, just so you don't have, in case you're looking for something and those candidates aren't available anymore, it's not in this report. But their resume itself is still in our resume bank. So that is the difference between those two numbers. The resume bank just has all of the information, whereas this candidate reports is very particularly the information since May that's been uploaded into our database. So the most fresh. Similarly, with the download site, you might decide that you don't want to get any of those other resumes, so you just select May, June, July, and you download them here. All right, so I'm not sure if there are any more questions in the Q&A to answer here or if the team has got them. If not, I can hand it over to Lucia.
There are definitely more questions. Okay, so if this is Q&A, we got some more coming. Let's see here. Excuse me, y'all. All right, can you clarify how to filter for candidates who are looking to apply to graduate programs?
All right, so let's see. So we'll go back to our resume bank.
And this is like if you're not searching for when they're graduating with like whatever degree.
Right. So in our filter, one of the options is the job seeker's preferred program. And for there, you can say the type that they're looking for. So in this case, it would be info on schools, undergraduate or graduate schools, or yeah, that would probably be the closest thing there that you would say. And that would kick off the filtering. And you could add other filters from there. But there is a wide variety of filters that we have in this system.
Awesome. And then Tawanda, did you already talk about bulk downloading? There are a few questions just coming in about that.
Yeah, so the platform here, this is all for searching and filtering within the platform. If you're trying to bulk download is when you would go to that site that we've set up particularly for you this year to download all of the resume information that's in our database. So the search and individual filtering and all of that can be done on the platform. You could look at their, pull up their individual emails, look at their candidates and do all of that, but there's not a bulk option here. The bulk options are either downloading it from the download page that we've created or using the candidate report profile and filtering that, and then maybe importing that into a different applicant tracking system to do a mass communication or anything like that.
We'll just go through. We have a few more questions. So if we have time, then great.
Yeah, I want to be cognizant of the original time that people were expecting this to end. So I'm not sure how much time we have. Someone let me know.
We're good. We're good. So if you're finished with your presentation, let's just take questions until people have to leave. I'm sure some folks had to go, so they're starting to drop off. But if there's other questions, we'll at least take the next 15 minutes and respond to questions, since we got started a little late, if that's okay.
Just have a few more, so.
Okay, perfect.
So we'll be sending, I see a question about the recording. So we'll definitely be sending out this recording after the meeting. So if you missed any part of the content, we'll definitely send that out to you.
And it'll come with the slides. So like we mentioned earlier, I went through this demo, but there are slides that go over each aspect of what we talked about here too, to help jog your memory or communicate with other coworkers who didn't make it to this.
And folks want to know if we'll be sending out the Q&A as well.
I know we're collecting the questions on the Q&A to make sure we have the common questions asked. I'm not sure if we're sending it out. Is anyone?
So I've asked in the chat that anyone who wants another question answered that we don't answer here, send it to resumesupport@anitab.org. That way we'll have your email address to be able to send you a response. Also, that will be your support mechanism as you start to use the resume database and the job board. That's where we will be answering questions in general. So that support line will be open through the end of the year. And that's where we can take your questions.
Okay.
But we're trying to answer everyone that we have here today, but if you have other questions or yours doesn't get responded to for some reason, please send it to resumesupport@anitab.org. Yes, I spent much of my career in marketing, and I know that if I repeat this 7 times, it's probably going to stick. So that email address again is resumesupport@anitab.org. Go ahead, Talanda.
We'll go ahead and pop that in the chat. So if folks on chat can go ahead and pop that in there.
I've done resume that. Support.
Okay, awesome. Thank you.
Awesome.
So back to just some questions around the actual database. Can you go back and slowly scroll through a candidate's profile from the top to the bottom? Additionally, there's a question, when a candidate updates their profile, does that include an updated resume?
Right, okay. So the candidate profile and the resume are two separate things, technically. So they can update their profile without updating their resume, or just update their resume without updating the questions in the profile. So I'll go over that. Either way, the last updated date would be updated, so you would know that there is something new in there. So for instance, this is one resume we have, their information, and at the top in table format, essentially in the PDF version, you would have these questions and then their answers. So these are our standard profile questions and their answers. And this is how we'll get all those filters. And so let me just continue through here, including with preferences, all of this information is part of the profile. And then underneath the profile questions is the resume. So in this case, this resume retained most of its formatting, and it is just the resume that they've uploaded. And so the PDF version of that is the same. It's just slightly formatted differently. You have the profile information that's at the top in the preferences, and then the resume.
I'd also like to add to that in our communication with job seekers, we are definitely giving them a lot, letting them know that they should probably update both their profiles and their resumes. So in any documentation that we send to them, we definitely encourage that.
Yes. Definitely important to have updated job seeker information in here. So we're working on that for you.
Just again, a few more questions. It seems like folks still like want some clarification between the 2200 and the 15K.
Okay. Another thing to note is that we do have various events. And so I'm just going to go over this again on the from the My Account page. One moment. So this Career Center holds our virtual GHC resume database, as well as our Braid database, community database. There's a few other databases that are in here. And so they're segmented out. So the numbers that you'll see on the download section are for the particular events, and then the resume bank just holds all of the resumes. And so one of the things to note that's important here, the big difference between this 2000 number and the 15,000 number is that 15,000 is all the resumes that have been submitted since last year, everything that we have in our system. It's there to make sure that if someone's still available for a job posting, that you still see their information and it's accessible to you. The candidate reports is very new and we've only recently rolled it out, and it has the information that's updated since May. So the most accurate information that's most up to date in that new system are these 2,300 resumes, right? That doesn't mean that someone from a prior resume database time period hasn't gone in and updated their information, but that's in the resume bank. But this is information that we know has been updated since May.
There was a question asking if we had any indication or estimate on the number of resumes we're expecting for GHC. So we don't have an exact number, but we can let you know that just based the moment we put out our communication, we received an influx of new registrants, and we'll also continue to send out blasts to job seekers, making them aware that the database is open so they can continue to update those profiles. So we do expect an influx of resumes, especially closer to the event.
Yes, definitely see kind of a bell curve there, and we're already getting a lot of numbers, as Kobe said.
Okay, and then the last question that's open is, there's about 13K from 2019. Is there a distinction inside the resume bank? Is this by date modified?
Right, so in the resume bank, that'd be the easiest way to filter. So you can, of course, sort here, but then you could also do a filter on, there's a last updated date at the bottom here. So within a day, a week, a month, 3 months, 6 months, and last year. So at this point, if it's within the last 3 months, it's one of our newest communications out to job seekers, and we know that they're actively looking for jobs. And then there are the other ranges in here as well. So if you're looking for specifically those older resumes, then they're in they're in that downloads page that we have separately. But through the system itself, you can also just keep your filter on within the last month, for instance, and know that you're always getting information that they've updated within the last month.
And there are no more questions in the Q&A.
Yay. I'm sure people will come up with more questions, but that is fine. Happy to take them at resumesupport@anitab.org. And then I know there are closing comments, so I will turn it back over to Lucia.
We're a little bit over time, so my closing comments are, thank you for joining us today. This is one of a couple of solutions we have, and as solutions become available, we'll make sure that we let you know, probably by email. So thank you so much for not only your questions and your attention, but also for your suggestions that we're capturing from the Zoom. If you have another suggestion, again, resumesupport@anitab.org is where we're capturing all of that. And we'll look forward to talking with you and working with you throughout this sponsorship process. So thanks. Talk later. Bye.